Hello viewers, welcome to linuxhelp.com. In this session we will going to see how to create a new user and configure mail server setting on OpManager. First of all, user management on OpManager is creating a user in OpManager and provide required privileges to them. The options to create a user is available only for the admin login account or those accounts which have full control privilege to access the OpManager. And second thing, mail server setting. The OpManager allows you to configure email alerts to get notified and any fault in your network. That's the time the OpManager will send email features uses the mail server setting configured here as the default setting for email alerts across OpManager. However, specific requirement can be configured while setting up a profile for each feature. For example, notification profile, scheduled reports and etc. So now I'm going to open a terminal. Now we are in a OpManager server. In my case, I have already installed OpManager on my system. So I have to just check it out there, whether the service is running or not for OpManager. The service is already running. So now I'm going to open a OpManager console. Here I have to give my IP address. And then here I have to give my port number to accessing OpManager. Now we are in the login page of OpManager. Here I have to click login. After the successful login, we are in a dashboard of OpManager. Since I have configured localhost only on OpManager, so now I'm going to open a setting for creating a new user. And then here we can see the user management. The user management configuration console is open now. And then here we can see the default username profile. So now I'm going to add a new user. Now we are getting a configuration console, and then here we can choose the type of role for creating a new user. I have to choose operator. If you want to create a new user as administrator, please choose administrator. The major difference between administrator and operator user is the administrator user have unrestricted access to perform read and write operation in OpManager. They can add, remove devices, troubleshoot issues, change configuration and more without any limitation. They have complete access. The operator user have read only unrestricted access in OpManager. They can grant a further access by the administrator user. So here I have to choose my operator user. And then here we can see the two type of user type. One is the local authentication, another one is the radius authentication. Local authentication is the by default authentication, and then another one is the radius authentication. The radius authentication is a remote authentication dial-in user service. It's an industry standard client and server authentication protocol that enhances security by protecting networks from unauthorized access. So here I have to choose local authentication, and then here I have to choose username. And then here you can choose your phone number or a mobile number. I doesn't configure any phone number or mobile number. Here I have to choose my password. And then here I have to configure the email ID for new user. After the configuration, we have to click next. Now we are in a scope configuration. The scope configuration is for monitoring. You can provide this user on access to either all devices or only selected business views. If you are choosing all devices, the user will have access to all the devices of NetFlow, NCM and Firewall. If you are choosing selected business views, you can give the access to all business views with the selected all options and business views without title and untitled options. I have to choose all devices. Then I have to choose click save. Now the user has been created. And then if you want to configure the radius server setting, please click here. And then here we can choose the IP address. And then here we can authentication port number for the server. And then here you can choose your server secret password. And then here you can choose your protocol as a point-to-point authentication and so on. After giving the details, you have to click save for creating a radius server setting. And then here we can see the password policy. And then here we can configure the minimum password length. And then here we can configure the enforcing history. And then here we can see the password complexity as a simple or a complex and so on. These are all the user management configuration on OpManager. The user management configuration session is completed. Now I'm going to configure the mail server setting. Now we are in a mail server setting configuration console. First of all, OpManager allows you to configure the email alerts to get notified on any fault in your network. The OpManager will send the email features uses the mail server setting configured here as the default setting for email alerts across the OpManager. So here we have to choose the server name. I have to choose the server name as the smtp@gmail.com. And then here I have to choose the port number 587. And then here I have to choose the time.second. And then here I have to configure the from email ID. And then here I have configured destination mail ID. And then here we can configure the username and password for a from user mail ID. And then here you can choose your secure connection detail. Then we have to click save. The mail server setting is updated now. And then if you want to verify your configuration, please click test mail. If you are pressing a test mail, this email ID will be considered as a default to email ID while creating an email based SMS notification profile. If you had second mail server in your network, select add a second mail server and provide a detail. In case of failure in the primary mail server, OpManager uses the second mail server to send the email to alert. In this session, I hope you understand how to configure user management and mail server setting on OpManager. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel LinuxHelp. If you want to further more videos, please visit www.linuxhelp.com. If you have any queries, please mail to support@linuxhelp.com.